Bottom line is, your net worth can tell you so many things. Yet, it is the simplest way for you to gauge if you are financially successful. From Ramfer Financials. Kamusta po mga ka-RFF? I hope you are still safe, healthy, and well. Kahit na po may increase na naman po ng bagong variant, itong Delta variant, ingat po tayong lahat. Maraming salamat po sa patuloy ninyong pagsuporta at pagmamahal na binibigay sa amin dito sa Ramfer Financials. Talaga pong binabasa namin ang mga comments ninyo isa-isa at talaga namang nakakapagbigay ito ng inspirasyon at lakas ng loob para may pagpatuloy pa po namin ang aming mga financial advocacies. And so for today, we will be discussing another very interesting topic, this time about net worth. Have you heard about that? Well, you know, net worth is an often misunderstood term. We tend to think that it only relates to billionaires, to millionaires, to celebrities. However, it doesn't relate to us ordinary individuals. But we have to remember that we all have a net worth, and understanding this can be a powerful tool that can guide us in all our current and future financial decisions. So what is net worth exactly? Simply put, it's your total assets minus your total liabilities. And how do we increase it? Short answer would be to spend less than what you make. And then the remaining, you have to invest it in appreciating assets that grow over time. So what are the five easy ways for us to increase our net worth? Of course, on top of the list would be to max out on your retirement plans. Most employers offer and provide retirement plans that have desirable tax characteristics. Other tax advantage plans like PERA or the Philippine Equity and Retirement Account Law are also very much available. In fact, there are many employers out there that even have matching plans for your retirement money. So, it even helps your retirement funds grow at a faster pace. So, let's take advantage of all of these programs from your companies. Imagine, para lang naman kayo nag-iipon ng inyong mga regular savings programs every month. Ang kagandahan nito ay sa parehong halaga na dodoble pa po ang maaari ninyong maipon as retirement fund na bigay ng inyong mga kumpanya. Maxing out on your retirement contributions has a twofold benefit. First is that they defer your taxable income to your lowest earning years, and the second is that it increases your available generative assets. The second easy way for you to increase your net worth is for you to pay your high interest paying debt. If you have a credit card or other high interest paying debt instruments, you have to eliminate them quickly as soon as you can. This is the number one threat to increasing your net worth. We have to learn to pay off in full all our credit card balances every month. Huwag po tayong maging revolvers. Alam niyo po ba yung mga revolvers? Yung mga tao na may utang sa credit card na kahit naman po may pangbayad sa mga utang nila sa credit card companies ay nagiiwan po ng konting halaga, and they just revolve it every month. Alam nyo, wala po tayong niloloko sino man but ourselves. Kasi, tandaan nyo po, kahit naman po mga maliliit na lamang na amounts na ito, pag biglang nakalimutan po natin ang due date na mga yan, ay mapapatawan pa po tayo ng mga tinatawag na interest charges. And so, kung lalong-lalo na po ay may kapasidad naman po tayong bayaran in full yung ating mga pagkakautang or ang ating mga balances sa ating mga credit card companies, ay kinakailangan matuto at maging disiplinado po tayong bayaran na ito on a regular basis. Lagi niyo pong babalikan yung formula ng net worth. Di ba po? Total assets minus total liabilities and obligations is equal to your net worth. And so, pagka hindi po natin napapababa ang mga obligasyon nito, ay patuloy lamang pong magiging mababa ang ating mga net worth. The third easy way for you to increase your net worth is to keep an adequate amount in your emergency funds. Again, paulit-ulit po namin tinuturo dito sa channel namin na kinakailangan po, meron po tayong natatabi sa ating mga bank account na mga tinatawag nga pong emergency funds that is worth at the very least 3 to 6 months worth of your monthly living expenses. You have to remember that an emergency fund is an integral part of your financial portfolio as it covers the unexpected expenses. Having an ample amount in these instruments helps you not rely on all of these loans or credit cards should the unexpected emergencies happen. Marami po kaming mga kliyente na nadinig na nagsimula lamang ang kanilang pagkakabaon sa utang nang dahil lamang sa isang simpleng emergency na kesyo tinakbo ang kamag-anak sa hospital at wala po silang pangbayad para po ma-discharge yung kamag-anak nilang yon. Nagpa-pile up po kasi ang mga maliliit na bagay nito na eventually hindi ninyo mamamalayan ay lumalaki na pala. At again, isa po ito sa major threats ng pag-increase ng ating mga net worth. The fourth easy way for you to increase on your net worth is for you to cut down on your monthly expenses. When you spend less money every month, you'll have more resources to accumulate. Practice po delayed gratification instead of instant gratification. Always stick to your budgets para hindi po tayo napapariwara sa ating mga financial journey. Take a look at your budgets. Review them regularly. Check out and understand your current expenses so that you'll be able to identify which ones you can cut back. Also, develop the habit and the discipline of noting down your regular and daily expenses, and you will be shocked to find out eventually how much all of these little expenses eat up on your monthly income. You see, the intent is not for you to really stop dining out or stop all of these Netflix subscriptions, Wi-Fi, internet connections, and all that stuff, but to be more aware and conscious of your spending habits. Because as you know, the more you spend, the less money you'll be able to keep for your savings and investments. Which leads us to the last easy way for you to increase your net worth, and that is to maximize your assets. Just as it is as important for you to understand your liabilities, it's also very important to understand your other resources and assets as well. Find time to also review and assess how much all of your assets and other resources are really worth. Like for example, your house, your jewelries, your car, and many other stuff that you have, so that you can all incorporate them in your inventory, and it will give you a bigger picture, a clearer view of what you owe and what you own. And then when you already have a complete financial inventory, that's the time that you will be able to identify which ones can be reallocated to more or higher yielding investment instruments. Let's not keep everything in one basket. And always remember that diversification will always be key to financial freedom. You should earn more from your cash. You see, traditional savings and time deposit products earn next to nothing, which means you could be missing out on significant money if you leave most of your funds parked in all of these instruments. And never do this alone. Always ask the help of a professional, like a financial planner or a consultant who can really guide you towards the right instruments that can match your investment objectives and risk appetite towards the right investment instruments. And one way for you to also maximize on your assets is for you to review your existing savings accounts. It's an important way for you to declutter and to organize your savings such that you can close down all existing accounts that are no longer active so that you can save up on the regular fees that are being charged to you just in case there are monthly maintenance fees or that the principal that is required for you to maintain those accounts falls below the minimum. And aside from you saving up from all of these unnecessary fees, it also helps you keep track of your funds better. Bottom line is, your net worth can tell you so many things. Yet, it is the simplest way for you to gauge if you are financially successful. And at the end of the day, if you want to achieve financial success, you really have to have the right attitude and perspectives in wealth building. And so I hope this short video has somehow helped you in one way or another. And if you think you have friends and relatives who might be interested of this same video, I hope you can give it a thumbs up and share this video to them. And for those who haven't yet, I hope you can click to subscribe to our official YouTube channel, Ramfer Financials, and tap the bell button for our future notifications and other video uploads. And so this has been June Fernando saying thank you so much for watching, for your continued support, and we'll see you in our next video. God bless.